Smita, welcome you to the YouTube channel of Excellent Tutorials. Today I am going to continue with chapter matter which I started in the previous class. In the last chapter, we have discussed about what is matter, what are the properties of matter, various terms related to it, all the three states of matter, kinetic molecular theory. Today I am going to discuss about change of state of matter using kinetic energy, that is interconversion. So we have broadly divided matter into three states: solid, liquid and gas. So we have three states of matter broadly, otherwise we have plasma also. But in general, we have three states of matter. So these three states of matter are interconvertible. We can change one state of matter into another by changing temperature, increasing or decreasing pressure, and also by changing both temperature and pressure. So what we can say? State of matter is interconvertible. So children, what is interconversion? Interconversion means change of the state of matter from one form to another and then back to the original form. Like here in this diagram we can see solid changes into liquid on being melted. When liquid is evaporated, it changes into gas or vapor. When gas is condensed, it changes into liquid. Now this liquid again changes back to the original form, that is solid, on solidification or fusion. So what we have seen here, that matter is interconvertible. It can change from solid to liquid to gas, then liquid and then back to the solid. So this is known as change of state, and this change of state can be brought by changing the temperature, by increasing or decreasing the pressure, or by doing both. So students, we are going to study about change of temperature in this particular class. What happens to the matter when their temperature is increased or decreased? There are various terms related to this change. Like you have already seen, melting, evaporation, condensation, solidification or fusion. We are going to discuss about it in detail. What is melting, what is evaporation, condensation, solidification and so on. Now during this change of state, energy is either absorbed or evolved. Change of state also involves change in the heat energy. Whether the energy will be absorbed or evolved, we'll discuss about it. In which cases heat energy is absorbed and under which situation heat energy is evolved. So before we go into the detail of the terms related to it, I would like to make you understand a few things which is of equal importance while you study change of state. Like latent heat. For you, this is a new term. You are going to study about latent heat for the first time in class 8. So what is latent heat? So children, you have seen that a matter changes from one state to another and then it comes back to the original form. So during the change of the state of matter, heat energy is either absorbed or evolved. So the heat energy which is absorbed or evolved, it means that throughout the change, heat energy should keep on increasing. Like suppose when we have started heating solid, when you heat solid, it starts getting melted. After getting melted, it changes into liquid state. But in between, there is a phase when some of the particles are in the solid state, whereas some of them are in the liquid state. That is the phase where both solid and liquid are in the simultaneously, we have got both in that particular content. So at that time, the heat energy is of course being absorbed by the solid. But that heat energy we can't see as an increase in the temperature in the thermometer. If we are immersing thermometer into that solid while it is getting melted into liquid, remember that the heat energy is being supplied to the solid throughout, but still the temperature is not increasing throughout. First it increases, it reaches up to its melting point. So children, what is melting point? Melting point or melting temperature or melting temperature is the temperature at which solid starts getting converted into liquid from the entire surface of the liquid. So when the solid will change into liquid, so heat energy is continuously being supplied to it. Heat energy is being absorbed by the solid, but the rise in the thermometer is not seen after some time. Why does it happen? The temperature becomes constant. The temperature becomes constant. So why does the temperature remains constant? Where does the heat energy which is absorbed by the solid goes? So while we are heating solid into liquid, after some time the temperature becomes constant and the heat energy which is absorbed by that matter is utilized in overcoming the state of matter. Like when the solid is changing into liquid, in the solid the molecules are very close to each other, so the inter-particle force of attraction is maximum. So in order to overcome inter-particle force of attraction, solid needs extra energy. That extra energy it takes from the heat which it is absorbing. So till the time entire solid particle changes into liquid, it does not show a rise in the thermometer, although the heat energy is being absorbed by the solid. So this heat energy which is absorbed is known as latent heat of fusion. And what is this latent heat? It is the hidden heat energy. It means that the temperature is showing something else, but the fact is something else. The temperature shows only the melting point or the melting temperature. For example, when ice changes into water, the melting point of ice is 0 degree Celsius. So the temperature does not increase from 0 degree Celsius until and unless the entire solid present in the container changes into liquid. So we can define latent heat of fusion as the quantity of heat energy that has been absorbed in joules to convert 1 kilogram of solid into liquid without any change in the temperature. So this is the heat energy that has been absorbed. It will remain in that matter, but it will not be shown in the thermometer. Likewise, students, we have got latent heat of vaporization. Now during latent heat of vaporization, the liquid changes into its vapor or gaseous state. So when the liquid will change into its gas or vapor state, that time also heat energy will be absorbed. Here the same thing will happen. The heat energy will be absorbed, but that heat energy absorbed will not change into the rise of temperature. Means the thermometer will not show you a rise in the temperature. And that extra energy which that liquid is absorbing is going to help that liquid to overcome the interparticle force of attraction in order to change liquid into its gaseous state. So latent heat is the hidden heat energy. Latent heat is a constant temperature. It is a temperature which remains constant. So every pure substance has a particular melting point, boiling point, condensation point, which signifies its characteristics. So melting point, boiling point, condensation point, freezing point are fixed and they remain constant throughout the change. Now we are going to discuss about the various terminologies that are involved during the change of the state of matter. See, we have already discussed that heat energy is either absorbed or evolved. So there are certain processes during the change of the state of matter in which heat energy is absorbed, whereas in others it is evolved. Like when we are heating solid into liquid, then the heat energy will be absorbed. The process is melting or fusion. Now when we are heating liquid so that it can change into gaseous state, again heat energy is absorbed here. So the process involved is evaporation and boiling. Now on the contrary, when we are cooling a gas, means here the heat energy will be evolved. So when we are cooling a gas, it changes into liquid, and when it is further cooled, it changes into solid. So here the heat energy will be released or evolved, and the process involved is condensation and freezing or solidification, we can say. So for example, when ice is melted, it changes into water, and when water is further heated, it changes into water vapor. Now this water vapor when cooled changes into water, and water when further cooled, it changes into ice. So we can very well understand through this example that there is a change of the state of matter which involves absorption as well as evolution of energy. So now let us discuss about the various terms, various definitions that we have discussed here in short. So melting, the first process is melting. So melting is a process of heating of the solid. During the melting, what do we do, students? We heat the solid. So when the solid is heated, it changes into liquid. So now all the solid does not get changed into liquid at once. First of all, the temperature rises. When we are giving heat energy, then the temperature will rise, and the temperature will keep rising till it reaches its melting point. The moment it reaches its melting point, it will stop showing a rise in temperature. Again, why? Because of latent heat of fusion. That heat energy will be utilized in overcoming the bond between the particles in the solid. So, melting is the process of heating the solid. Now then, what is fusion? Fusion is that phase, you can say during melting only. You know, during the melting, both the solid and the liquid are present together. But as soon as the fusion process will start, means fusion is the advanced process of melting, you can say that. Once the temperature has reached, during melting, once the temperature has reached to its melting point, after that, when there will be no rise in the temperature, at that time, fusion is going to start. When the state changes from solid to liquid, it is called fusion. So during the fusion, the energy is utilized in breaking the bond and making the liquid, means ki overcoming the bond and going into the next state. So in this both heating and fusion, what is happening? Heat energy is being absorbed. Now let us come to another term, and that is evaporation. Students, evaporation is a very slow process. Evaporation, you can see even in the normal, you know, like things like, for example, when we are spreading our clothes in any cloth line, after a few hours, what do we see? That the clothes become dry. It is because of evaporation. So evaporation, you can say, is the process of change of liquid into its gaseous or vapor state at any temperature. It means that when we start heating, the temperature rises, but it does not reach to its boiling point at once. The boiling point will be reached only after some time. gradually the temperature rises and rises and reaches its boiling point. And once it reaches its boiling point, then the process of boiling starts. So boiling takes place from the entire surface of the liquid, and during the boiling there will be no rise in the temperature. The temperature will remain constant again because of latent heat of vaporization, and that latent heat of vaporization provides hidden heat energy to this liquid molecules, which will overcome their attractive forces and change into another state, that is gas or vapor. So both are related terms. There is a difference. Difference is that evaporation is slow. It is a surface phenomena. It can take place at any temperature. But boiling is a entire, you can say, not entire surface. It takes place from the entire surface, not only from the upper surface. It starts getting evaporated from the bottom, from the side. So evaporation and boiling are related terms. Boiling point is the temperature at which the boiling starts taking place. Now let us come to the condensation. Condensation is a process of change of gases into its liquid state. If any gas changes into its liquid state, then the heat energy is released. So heat energy is released during this process, and it happens at a particular temperature, and that particular temperature is known as condensation point. So now another thing which is related to heat evolution is prism. Now when the liquid will be further cooled, it changes into solid. Here a lot of heat energy is evolved. So the process involved here is prism. We also call it solidification. So frizzing is a process by which liquid changes into its solid state, and during this process heat energy is released. Now there are certain solid. Here you can see solids are changing into liquid and then into their gaseous state. But there are certain solid which, without getting changed into liquid, they directly change into their gaseous state. So those solids that directly gets changed into their gaseous state are known as sublimable substances. What do we call them? Sublimable substances. For example, iodine, camphor, naphthalene. You must have seen these substances. They don't change into liquid. They directly change into their gaseous state. So this process has been termed sublimation. So what is sublimation, students? The process of change of solid directly into the gaseous state without turning into liquid. So they don't change into liquid. Without changing into liquid, they directly change into their gaseous state. Now again vice versa means, if the solid will directly change into gas, so gas will also directly change into solid. So this process has been termed as deposition. So when a substance changes from gaseous state to their solid state directly without passing through the liquid state is known as deposition. Like iodine, camphor, naphthalene, their vapors are obtained by deposition method. We can obtain their vapors by deposition method. So in this deposition method, what we are doing? We are changing their vapors into the solid state. So deposition, sublimation, these all are also important terms that are involved during the change of a state of matter. So children, today I am winding up my class and this chapter of matter is over. So you need to go through the chapter, try to do the exercises. In case of any problem, you can get back to me through phone, and if you have any problem, you can talk to me. So students, thanks, and please don't forget to subscribe, like and share my channel.